Hey guys, this is the end of the week that we dedicated to the band Led Zeppelin. Last song that we're gonna review really awesome. It's called When the Leeve Breaks, Led Zeppelin 4th album. Can't wait to start it as a class, but I already started the class, so please follow the instruction of the class, which means only one rule, no complaint. If you're gonna complain, we're not gonna have a deal. I can call your parents or call your wife. Mm-hmm. Yes, my school of teachers taught me well how to do a punishment for the bad boys. Listening, ding 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 ding. When the leeve breaks. Just wanted to, leave that intro as it is, because such a powerful, brutal, I would say, male energy, like, brum. When the strength of the man, not in the aggression and the physical strength, but his energy that could be dominant, but also a pleaser of the woman, everything here just works exceptionally. Okay, this always a tricky part, because before you say this is Led Zeppelin song, you need to really check several times, because this is not originally Led Zeppelin songs. It was a country blues that was written by Lizzie Douglas, better known as a Memphis Minnie, and Kansas Joe McCoy in 1929. Boom! It's interesting, right, to listen.
If it keeps on raining, levee's going to break. If it keeps on raining, levee's going to break. And the water gonna come and have no place to stay.
Of course, we hear that it's very different generation. Recording has very different quality, of course, and the song just different. Led Zeppelin really, as always, made the song huge. There was a great Mississippi flood in 1927, and the lyrics of the song reflect experiences during that upheaval caused by it. Did you hear harmonica? You know that instrument? Robert Plant played harmonica in this song. Interesting fact, right? It's me, yes. Very serious class.
Oh, last night I sat on the levee, you know.
very cool. Very cool ending. Never paid attention. Very cool ending. When it's, we will call it, cover version, we can't really say what Led Zeppelin meant with that song because it's not originally written by them. There are people who think that Led Zeppelin stole a lot of songs. And I don't understand why we need to choose words. Objectively speaking, this is the fact that they took some parts from here and there. They made them for sure the hell whole lot like different, super amazing material. I want to tell you how many songs Led Zeppelin actually covered. Let's start from the Baby I'm Gonna Leave You, originally written by Ian Breeden. Then Dazed and Confused, very cool song, however it was written by Jake Holmes. Black Mountainside by Birch Gench, sorry. Then Whole Lotta Love, Willie Dixon, You Need Love. Then The Lemon Song, Hole in a Wolf again, that was called Killing Floor. Then Bring It On Home, written by Sonny Boy Williamson. Then song Hats Off to Harper, originally written by Booker White. There is an amazing song that we reviewed actually, Since I've Been Loving You. Then our famous example, Stairway to Heaven, was written by Spirit. What's interesting that all these songs originally written very close to when Led Zeppelin took them. So in that time, they were like popular, some were played. Custard Pie has two influencers, Sleepy John Estes and Blind Boy Fuller. Boogie with Stu by Richie Valens, and it's called Oh My Head. We can't deny that there was a several lawsuits cases where Led Zeppelin was sued for the lack of credits to the songwriters, right? That is the point of a lot of hate, that people like decided to concentrate on that. They choosing to find in that something wrong. But personally, for me, in case of Led Zeppelin, honestly, it doesn't bother me. They changed it so much, it's like new songs. They took the riffs, maybe some melodies. However, it's a lot of songs, right? A lot of songs, not two. It's like was their hobby or something. But I just trying to explain you guys that it doesn't make sense to be aggressive about some people's opinion, like, well, they stole half of their hits and it took them a while to mention and give these authors credits. And other people would say, no, this is the greatest band ever lived, blah, blah, blah. The both sides has some strong points because it's a very great band. They have such a signature sound, they are huge influencers, they deserve their fame. But in the same time, the fact is, yes, yes, even if they created from the old songs such a crazy, impossible, super cool things. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Basically, if you love something, you will find arguments and points to protect it and like advocate it. I remember I listened to Robert Plant's solo album. There is actually very like many sad songs, different vibe. We know Coverdale Page collaboration, super sexy, cool things. Even when band separated and go different directions, it doesn't mean that we need to stop support their members because it's the same people, the same minds, creativity and talents. On this note, I'm gonna tell you, this is the beginning of the summer and of course the study not gonna be so tense, but we're gonna have a summer camp. It's just a few days a week, but you need to understand that anyway, you can call your wife or your parents. So yes, because I have a phone and I know how to use it, because I googled it, because I support the local businesses. Mm-hmm. Thank you for participation of this class. I'll see you next week. Don't be late.